I'm joined by local reporter Charles Kim. Charles, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5.
Good morning, Bill. How's it going?
It is going great. Not so great this morning for Assemblywoman Donna Simon. What do you think happened? I mean, you heard what I was just talking about before, that everybody calls and they're frustrated and my vote doesn't count. Here you've got a progressive liberal elected in a Republican district. Now, it tells me that voting actually does matter. What do you think happened?
Well, there's a couple things there. I just heard your previous caller. And the one thing is, in 2011, the Democratic legislature, the majority, changed the district to include heavily Democratic South Brunswick and Princeton. So you really can't say anymore that it's a Republican district like it was in the old days when Pete Biondi first got in.
Right.
Then it was solidly Republican. But by adding, South Brunswick is the largest township within the district, and that's heavily Democrat. And Princeton, of course, is heavily Democratic.
Yep.
And Andrew Zwicker has very strong ties in both communities, not only with the Princeton Plasma Lab where he works, but he also in South Brunswick. And one of the reasons I think he got in was because the athletic group in South Brunswick that supports high school athletics, his son, Matt Golden, was a big football player in town, and he is known throughout those circles. And they came out heavily to vote in the Board of Education election for the two incumbents that also support athletics. So I think a lot of those votes went to him and probably certainly the 78 that put him over the top.
Yeah. Well, I mean, and there you go. I mean, that to me, there's your answer to every vote counts because it can actually be that close. Now, do you expect the Republicans are going to challenge this and go for a recount? Are they going to drag this out or accept the loss?
That I don't know. I did speak to both Andrew Zwicker and Donna Simon over the weekend. And the sense I got is they're both kind of waiting, and especially Donna is kind of waiting to see, you know, how things look. I mean, you have to remember, this was a very close election.
Yeah.
Each of the candidates only walked away with 25% of the vote. If you look at the span between Jack Cittarelli, who won the most votes, and Maureen Vella, who was the least, you know, the fourth place vote getter, the span between them is only 0.82%.
Wow.
So it's only, you're talking...
Wow, think about that.
534 votes between Cittarelli, who's definitely in, and Vella, who's definitely out. And he had Zwicker and Simon in the middle fighting for that, those 78 votes.
Yeah.
The difference between them is only 0.12%. So if Donna were to challenge this, then, and what would happen if they do find problems with votes, then maybe take some away from Cittarelli, who is right now they're guaranteed in, you know, into Trenton. That could actually take votes away from him, and there's only a 534-vote margin. So they're going to have to weigh that into consideration. I would think that she might probably challenge it. I mean, you're looking at the 78 votes. What is the statistical probability that there are 78 voting errors in 32,000 votes cast?
I'd say they're pretty good.
I would, too.
Pretty good,
If I write a story with 32,000 words and I go to spell check, I almost guarantee you there's going to be 78 red underlines.
I don't know, Charles. I've read your stuff. I don't think so. I'm gonna say your error rate's going to be a little lower than the voting. I'll give you that.
Well, thank you, Bill. Most of my editors would not agree with that, but that's okay.
All right. Well, thank you for the perspective, Charles. I appreciate it. Where can people read your stuff? You're in Tap South Brunswick. Is that it?
It's Tap into South Brunswick and Cranberry, and people can get there at either www.tapintosouthbrunswick.net or www.tapintocranberry.net.
All right, Charles, thank you. We'll be talking soon, I'm sure, as the saga and the drama with the potential recount continues. Thanks for calling me and joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Have a great day, Charles.
You too, Bill. Thank you.
So there you have it. You know, Charles Kim, you know, he's been a local reporter in the Middlesex area for a long time, and he raises an interesting point that the way the map was drawn, it was almost made more competitive. So now I'm going to go to the next step and say, you know what, maybe every district ought to be made that competitive. Wouldn't it be fantastic if the winners and losers were only separated by a few hundred votes each time we went to the polls? Talk about driving voter participation and having your vote count instead of these lopsided victories. But I'll tell you, regardless of whether you think there's more balance in the 16th, it was still weighted toward the Republicans. And clearly in the 11th in Monmouth County, where Caroline Casagrande and Mary Pat Angelini lost their seats to Democratic challengers, that was absolutely a stacked Republican district. So again, the bottom line is it matters if you vote. And now this legislature is going to have to tackle some serious things.